Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel for episode 25. That's a lot of bumbling through Birthright, the campaign setting where we attempt to not completely screw up ruling countries and usually manage to. If you weren't here for the last session, make sure to check out the link down below to catch up on where we are. And if this is your first time here, make sure you go back to the beginning of the playlist and just learn all the things. It's been an adventure. But with that, let's get into the story. So for this session, we had 5 player characters, which is almost our full party. So we've got Roz, Brindis, Val, Rainier, and Renolfo with us. Jan is not here. He likes to go run his businesses and be very successful sometimes. And at the end of last session, we took care of the Ice Fiend, we chopped off its head, and now we need to head to a city or something because we can't just stay out here in the middle of nowhere. So we're headed to Alvika, which is at the head of the river, and it's in Hoganmark, and it's about a 1-day walk to get there, so it shouldn't take us too long. Then we can be like, hey, look what we got a head here, awesome, yeah. But as we're going along, suddenly the ice gets a little warm, and out from underneath the snow pops these like weird heated centipede like creatures called rumor hazards. They're not called rumor hazards, we just call them rumor hazards. And every time, as you might imagine, they come up, we start singing that Adele song. They're actually called rumor hazards. Rumor hazards. You can see how we got to rumor hazards. Because I guess they're hunting, one pops up in front of us and one pops up behind us, but Brindis just banishes the one in front of us so we can take the time to take care of the one in the back. Well, you know, Rainier does stupid things sometimes, like biting things that are clearly very hot and on fire and burns his mouth, but I mean, we've all done that. And after not too much of a fight, Val manages to kill this one, and then we just wait for a bit for the second one to arrive after returning from being banished. It comes back, Roz hits it with a lightning bolt, it's dead too, which is nice. And then Roz does a nature check because, like, these things kind of create tunnels as they come out of the snow. Are there more of these nearby? And likely there are, but at this point, we just kind of want to get to Alvika. We'll come back and we'll deal with this later. When we get there, it's pretty late at night, but we still want to be like, hey, look at this head we got. So we go to, it's not a jarl here in this country, they're called lairds. So we go, it's basically the queen's palace that we're going to. So we go there and the guards let us in because we've got this head. So yeah, awesome. And they also wake up the laird because it's kind of important to be like, hey, look, we killed this ice friend that was, you know, being mean. He wasn't really being a friend. We get to stay at the palace, which is pretty nice because, you know, we are royalty, so, and we killed the ice fiends, so that's awesome. So we stay there while we're in Alvika, and we decide to have a long rest because we got stuff to do. While we're on this long rest, Rainier goes and he does some pit fighting, Val goes back to bounty hunting, and Roz goes to try to learn about various things here. And Roz decides to make healing potions because we are going through them at pretty rapid pace. Unfortunately, there is a complication, and the seer from the area, Connalt, he wants to watch how the potions are made, and Roz is like, yeah, sure, why not? Here, this is how I make potions. And then she gives him one, and he's so stoked by that that he gives her a potion of double duration, which is pretty cool because it lets spells last longer, so not a bad thing to have. Rainier naturally goes and gambles, and Brindis continues to work on her proficiency, and I actually wrote down here where she's at. She's at week 6 of gun training proficiency, so 4 more weeks and she will be proficient with her musket, which is pretty awesome. While we are on this long rest, we heard talk of this really amazing adamantine sword called Sovereign that is up a little bit more north and guarded by 2 more ice fiends. And I mean, we took out the other ice fiend, not, it wasn't too hard. So why don't we get this cool sword, because Rainier really wants it. So we provision up and we head up to Frostshire, which is this fortress where it's rumored that Sovereign is being kept. And we don't have too much trouble. On the first day, we come across some ice mephits. They make everything kind of really foggy, but we kill them pretty quickly, and then nothing on the next 2 days. On that final day, we see Frostshire Fortress in front of us, and we fought some Ice Joten before, and what we did was we just set up a trap outside their house, and so when it came out through the door, bam, 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 prepared actions, fire, etc., super dead. So we do that here. and we knock on the door and the door's just open and nobody comes out. So Brindis has a cloak that she can put on that gives her invisibility. So we send her in to check out what is going on. And there's just these two ice fiends sitting at the end of a throne room on their chairs, and they're just watching and waiting for someone to show up. And by ice fiends, I mean Ice Joten. It says Ice Joten, but I've just been saying ice fiends a million times. These are Ice Joten, King and Queen Ice Joten. Brindis comes back outside after seeing these Ice Joten and be like, hey guys, they aren't fiends, they're Joten. And we say, well, let's just go in together. So we dig up our traps and bring the oil with us and stuff, and we go in. And we're like, we'll just pretend to be petitioners. But we go in and they just immediately decide to attack us. Which, I mean, yeah, I mean, if you were expecting someone and not that person comes in, I can kind of see it. Brindis banishes the queen, which, as I mentioned before, is a super convenient spell to have. And when Val pulls out Frostbreaker, who she initially got the super awesome powers for when we killed the other Ice Joten, Queen Holly appears and she's like, kill the Ice Joten, because she is bloodthirsty for those Ice Joten. She's got problems even in the afterlife. It's nice that we only have the king to deal with because we can focus all our attention on him, including magic like fireballs and stuff, and Rainier manages to take the king down, and then whoop, the queen appears. Fortunately though, we had a little bit of time to prepare between downing the king and when the queen shows up, so we did all that fun prepared stuff that we do. So there was oil on the ground where we knew she was going to appear. Roz had a prepared action for a fireball. We had like Molotov cocktails that we made. We were all good. She went down pretty quickly once she returned, which was kind of convenient because they throw rocks and it hurts. Once we take them out, we do a little bit searching, obviously, because we came here to try to find the adamantine sword, and we find Sovereign. It's underneath their thrones and it's a great sword. And so the person most ideal for it is Rainier, which is good because that's why we came up here anyway. We also find a little bit more treasure, like some money and some art, but then we decide to head back to Aldvica because we've done what we came here to do, and not only have we now taken out an Ice Joten that was terrorizing up here, and now on top of the Ice Fiend that we've taken out, we've taken care of two Ice Joten, so we're just really making it very safe up here. It takes us 3 days to get back to Aldvica. Nothing happens the first 2 days, and on the third day, about 180 feet ahead of us, we see a hunting party of Orogs. Well, that's not cool, and unfortunately they're quite far out of most people's range. Might be disadvantage or might even be not at all, but Roz has this convenient fireball, which is 150 feet, so she walks up 30 feet, drops it, manages to kill all 11 of them, so that was cool. It's like, don't worry about it, I got this. After that, without any problems, we return to Aldvica. We show everyone like this cool sword that we have, they think it's awesome, and we decide to have a long rest. Brindis does another week of gun proficiency, Renolfer naturally goes off and gambles and wins this time. It's been a little bit on and off. And at the behest of Rainier, Roz starts to enchant his new sword, Sovereign, because if you remember when we were fighting the Ice Fiend, Rainier had nothing to hit him with because all you could hit it with was magic. So it's very important to have magic weapons. Rainier is bankrolling this, which is nice because wizards are naturally pretty poor. And while she's doing the research on the enchanting, she's like, listen, we need a Hydra heart, so we need to figure out how and where to get one. Which means that while Roz is working on this, Rainier goes off and he's doing a little bit of research. Val, meanwhile, is doing some more bounty hunting. She's just like, look, let me come up to your city and I will clean it up for you. And then in his studies, Rainier finds a couple of interesting facts about Hydra. They're natural swimmers, so there's a good chance you could find them near rivers or the coasts or lakes or things like that. And they kind of like to stay in caverns when they're in colder climates for protection. And then there's that thing where if you cut off a head, two more will appear. And then also to help protect themselves, one head always stays awake. So that's a little bit of a problem for sneaking up. He asks around the city a bit and he finds out that there's a cave a little bit north along the coast that, hey, maybe there's gonna be a Hydra in. So I think you know where we're going next. So we head up along the coast, we find the cavern, and yes, there is a Hydra in it. It's, you know, it's one of those fights where you try not to cut off the head, but also the Hydra, if it takes X amount of damage, it's gonna regenerate an extra head anyway. So we definitely had a situation where we were getting more heads than we started with, but in the end, Rainier managed to kill it, pierced it in the heart, because we decided beforehand, either we'd take the heart back, or if Rainier could pierce it in the heart with Sovereign, we'd count that as the Hydra heart, and then the enchantment could continue. So when we get back to Aldvica, it's time to finish that enchantment. So we take a long rest and Roz enchants Sovereign. And now there is a magical weapon for Rainier to have. Meanwhile, he's out carousing with the nomads in the area because that's what he does. He's probably also telling them about his hunting lodge because that's also what he does, and about Dantir Island and how cool he thinks it is. Val continues to go bounty hunting, so she's like, again, she's just cleaning up the city. And Renolfer figures he has probably pushed his luck, so he goes and does some religious service because that's what he does when he feels like, maybe gambling isn't going to go very well. And with that, that is the end of that session. We did a lot. I mean, it was mostly for Rainier, it seems, but you know, it benefits us all if he has a magic weapon that he can use. And that was the end of the session. So with that, thanks for coming along on this adventure. And make sure you hit the like button if you enjoyed it, and also subscribe so you'll know when the next one comes out. And I will see you next time.